We have a little thing came up, a little special thing came up,
get up on the ring, get up there.
I just called me and said, hey, can I come over and something came up and I wanted to do something. I said, absolutely, you'd be honored, it would be a pleasure to have you be able to do that. So, with that said, to keep the spirit and brotherhood alive of boxing and sisterhood, turn it over to my main man, my boxing soulmate. I think that's all. Alright. Everybody pay attention.
Where's Pito?
Right here.
I need Pito and Mucci.
Pito and Mucci.
Pito and Mucci.
Come on, Mucci.
Former welterweight champion, the top contender, Pito Cardona and Marlon Starling. I've got something so special, it's ridiculous. You're not gonna believe it. Mucci might cry. So, Pito might cry. All right. Now listen. I'm telling you a story for you. There was a trainer in Hartford named Pepe Vazquez. He was a fighter. He was a trainer. Pepe, little Pepe, little guy. Pepe was a ball of energy. Every one of you guys would love Pepe. You guys would love this guy. He would come in here, and the whole room would just light up. He'd be screaming. He had a real deep voice. He had a funny voice, deep voice. He had a really flat nose. He would come in and the whole room would just be full of energy. So he was my trainer at one time. He was his trainer one time. He worked with Mucci at one time. He was a fighter himself. One night, title in the Harper City Center, he had the fight of the night with Carlos Figueroa. They both got an extra $1,000 because it was the best fight of the night. He was always in the great fight. Unfortunately, he passed away 11 years ago. He had a heart attack. So I've been in contact with his girlfriend all these years. She called me today. She's moving. She's moving to North Carolina. She had a whole bunch of stuff in the house. She didn't want to throw it away. She knew it meant something to someone. She didn't want to throw the stuff away, so she called me. I went and got it. She had some stuff for me, memorabilia, that type of thing. She had some other stuff. So I said, listen, I know exactly what to do with it. No problem. I'm about to do what I'm supposed to do with it. Now, you're gonna really like this. This is going to be crazy. You're going to really like it. Now.
No, you don't.
Now listen, first, this is Pepe's jacket. Been thinking, Jack. This is Pepe's jacket.
Look at that.
This is Pepe's jacket. September 15, 1989. Sorry. Listen, stop.
How's that? That's nice.
I had a fight in Vegas. who's got a tenant in Atlantic City. Pepe's girlfriend, that Maria. Maria came to our training session, right? And one of the boxers was looking at Maria. And Pepe didn't like it. So when we left that whole place and we went to Vegas, because the fight was in Vegas, right? It was a heavyweight, one of the big heavyweights, right? And Pepe said,
He wrestled at 106
pounds. If I see this guy, you know the boxer. He said, if I see this guy again, I'm knocking him in his head. Pepe said that, right? We have to go to Vegas and go to a gym, right? And the same guy that talking to Pepe Bell is in that gym. Pepe seen him. Pepe said, Pepe walked up on the guy, right? Pepe said, as he walked up on the guy got bigger and bigger. So as soon as Pepe got to him, Pepe said, how you doing?
Let me just tell you one more thing. It's kind of sad, but if you knew him, you'd understand. Pepe was, how old was he? He was in his late 40s. So he was later in his years, but he used to play basketball. He was this tall. He was the most aggressive batter. He didn't always go by the rules. You couldn't call fouls because he'd be there all day. But I'll tell you what happened. I found out he had a heart attack. I called him. I said, man, you all right? Yeah, he's in the hospital. He thought he was going to be home the next day. He said, yeah, I got a heart attack. And nobody told me. All he was worried about, he said, man, doctor said I'm not going to play basketball anymore. That was all he cared about. He wasn't going to play basketball with us. He was like almost 50. And he sounded so upbeat, which he always was, that I didn't go see him in the hospital the next morning because I figured he'd be home that night. He passed away the next day. Yeah. But all he was concerned about was he missed my event. Great Kyler passed away, one of my other boxers. I was doing an event. This is how special he was. I was doing an event to raise money to bury one of my boxers. Pepe would have normally been. Pepe called me from the hospital on my cell phone to tell me he couldn't come to apologize. I'm like, oh, what happened? Oh, I'm in the hospital. I had a heart attack. So he had a heart attack. One day away from death. And he called me to apologize because he couldn't come to my thing. And he was upset because he couldn't play basketball. That's in the house. That's Pepe Vazquez.
I want to thank Iceman John Scully, Marlon Magic Man Starling, his champion, our very own Pito Cardona, for sharing this very special moment. And thank above all, Pepe, who we all know and love, and we celebrate this very moment. And God bless you, Pat. Hey, guys.
That's it, people.
All right. Okay. How'd you do? Did you screw it up or you did all right? All right, people. COBA Boxing in Hartford. How many of you